Thank you for coming and watching my presentations. I'm Megumi Takeshita, EK Network Service. Now I talk about dissecting Wi-Fi 6 using Wireshark at this Sharkfest 21 virtual. At first, let me introduce myself. I'm Megumi Takeshita, packet otaku, a kind of packet nerd person. I also veteran of Sharkfest. I attended all Sharkfest from the first one. And I'm a small contributor of Wireshark. For example, I translate Wireshark UI into Japanese since Wireshark Qt versions, Wireshark 3. My session is about Wi-Fi 6 using Wireshark. Wireless technology evolves year by year from 11B at 1990, 11G, 11N, 11AC, and now 11AX. 11AX uses a high efficiency mode, HE mode. So now I show you 11AX protocols and the difference with former Wi-Fi using Wireshark. So let's start with the history and specifications of IEEE 802.11. Of course, Wi-Fi standards is standardized by IEEE, and the committee name is 802.11 is wireless sectors, and task group is alphabet name. It is somehow difficult. So Wi-Fi Alliance, famous for Wi-Fi certification logo. This organization names Wi-Fi standards as just a number, Wi-Fi generation numbers. For example, Wi-Fi 4 means 802.11n and uses 2.4 and 5 GHz band, and max logical speed is 1.2 gigabit per second, and max modulation means 64 QM. And Wi-Fi 5 uses 802.11ac standards, and it works only 5 GHz, and max logical speed is 3.5 gigabit per second, and modulation is 256 QM. Then Wi-Fi faces a problem. We can't speed up anymore because there are many difficulties, because wireless is half duplex and there are many interfere. So we need to change protocol standards drastically. Now we start Wi-Fi 6. Specification name is IEEE 802.11AX, and we can use 2.4 GHz as well as 5 GHz, and logical speed is jumped up to 9.6 gigabit per second, and max modulation is incredible 1024 QM. It means just one signal has 1024 10-bit information at a time. Some people know there are Wi-Fi 6E standards. It had these 6 GHz huge channels in Wi-Fi 6 technologies. Unfortunately, Japanese Ministry of Internal Affairs and Communications may not allow 6 GHz until 2022. Of course, there are next generation Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi 7 is now developing, and it calls as IEEE 802.11BE, and they use 2.4 and 5 and 6 GHz, tons of channels, and logical speed is 46 gigabit per second, and max modulation is 4096 QM. Anyway, in 2021, it's the age of Wi-Fi 6. So I talk about the Wi-Fi 6 technologies. There are big change of Wi-Fi 6. Wi-Fi is a kind of repeater of 10Base2 or 10Base5 until Wi-Fi 5. Wi-Fi system is half duplex. In old days, we use yellow cable, thick cables, to create the thick net. People call as 10Base2 TMBS5 network, there are transceivers to penetrate your cables and connect PCs. Or some people may remember CNET. CNET is a small cable using BNC connector to create half-duplex network. Until Wi-Fi 5, all clients connected with access point, and if some station send information, and other stations and access point never send a packet at a time. Clients share frequency, and one uses a channel, the other have to wait for the end of sending. Carrier sends multiple access with collision avoidance. Wired network is collision detection, but wireless is collision avoidance. Wi-Fi 6 uses OFDMA as well as OFDM. OFDMA is interesting system. We can communicate many stations at a time. It's just a simple diagram in wireless technologies. Before Wi-Fi 5, station occupy all the frequency at the moment when sending traffic. Other stations and access point have to wait at the moment. So time chart is as follows. If we use the same frequency from 20 MHz to 160 MHz, user A occupy RF, then user B use RF, and user A, user C, then user B. In this case, slow station uses a lot of time and there are a lot of latency in traffic congestions. The other hand, OFDMA divide one channel by resource unit. RU means a new unit to divide frequency with many users. Many stations send traffic at a moment using RU. RU assignment is divided by bandwidth. For example, we use 106 MHz bandwidth and 996 tone RU. We can share two users in one frequency. And if we use 26 tone RU with 160 MHz bandwidth, we can share 74 RU with multiple users. Wi-Fi 6 also uses multi-user MIMO. Multiple stations can send and receive signals using multiple antennas. And there are important term MCS. MCS means modulations and coding scheme. If access point and station communicate to each other, they change many MCS in case of RF situations. Wi-Fi physical spec has different set of number of special streams, a modulation type, a way to send bit by one wave, one signal. Coding rate means percentage of data streams used to transmit data. Guard interval, time between each of frames and bandwidth. There are many combinations of MCS, and AP and station chooses the adequate one to send data frames. MCS determines logical speed of a wireless network. Go back to history. Wi-Fi 4 MCS set uses max 64 QAM and 40 MHz bandwidth. And Wi-Fi 5, as known as very high throughput, uses max modulation is 256 QAM and max bandwidth is 160. Then, now we use Wi-Fi 6 high efficiency mode. We can use 1024 QAM and 160 MHz bandwidth. Wi-Fi 7, they are now developing as known as EHT, extremely high throughput, assumed to use 4096 QAM and 320 MHz bandwidth. It is important index known as MCX index seed. There are website of MCX index and I equip .11ax tables. This is a part of huge tables of MCS index from famous website mcsindex.com. I claim this table has much user FDMA 802.11ax. Let's look inside this table. There are a series of special streams and modulations and coding and resource unit and guard intervals. And each set of MCS, there are logical speed of communications. For example, lowest one, MCS index is 0, one special stream, binary phase shift keying, it means one signal just a 2-bit, and coding percentage is 50%, and guard interval is 3.2 microsecond by each frames. Logical throughput is 0.8 megabit per second. There are many combination set of MCS in 802.11ax. Now, it's time to capturing Wi-Fi 6 in Windows 10 environment. There are many new features such as OFDMA, multi-user MIMO, beamforming, higher order of modulations, power consumptions, coloring, new interval symbols, fast Fourier transformation size, and so on. For such informations, I recommend to see IEEE standard page, but it paid. Document. Okay. Anyway, it's time to capture Wi-Fi 6. We want to capture Wi-Fi 6 in Windows 10 environment. So we choose Tamsoft Combu for Wi-Fi and Intel AX200 M.2 wireless card. Of course, there are another way to capture Wi-Fi 6. For example, if you have some access point and you may use EXTCAP interface of Wireshark to connect access point worked as sniffer mode. And of course, you may use Linux monitor mode driver of Wi-Fi 6 or macOS and so on. In this time, we test ASUS RTX 89X access point. It supports Wi-Fi 6, 1024 QAM. Multi-user MIMO, and bandwidth is 160. I recommend to see DebiWiki or now WikiDebi. There are many registry of wireless card and access point, and you can refer which chipset or which driver or which CPU used for these devices. And this time, I use iPad Pro 11 second generation as stations. iPad Pro uses Qualcomm Snapdragon X55 and support 11AX and Wi-Fi 6 2x2 MIMO and max logical rate is 1200 megabit per second and bandwidth is max 80 MHz. And MCX index is 11. And let's talk about the capture side. I use Windows 10 Pro 64-bit and adapter is Intel X MGW connecting via this M.2 interface face. And capture software, I use Tamsoft Combu for Wi-Fi. I recommend to see WikiDevi site the wiki site to refer in details. So it's time to demonstrations. First demonstrations is just ping to wired PC. I set my access point as follows: SSID is Wi-Fi 6, security is clear text, and BSSID, AP's MAC address is F0 to F 74C4F5C0. And station MAC address is a private MAC address of IPAT pool is 060F5BDD20FA. And channel is 64. This process is at first connect IPAT to access point. Next, ping to wired PC. This time is 1.1.1.1 Internet Cloudflare servers. And click forget network to disconnect AP on my iPad. Use Comview to capture packets in this process. I use Comview for Wi-Fi with AX200 M.2 adapter to capture packets at channel 64. From capturing 64, I also use scanner mode of Comview for Wi-Fi to scan all 2.4 and 5 GHz channels and look for my access point. Then, set single channel mode and run Comview for Wi-Fi to capture packet at 64 channels. Then save trace file as NCFX, Tamsoft proprietary format, then export it as PKPNG. I use display filter to reduce the files. In Comview for Wi-Fi, we can see beacon frame like this. SSID is Wi-Fi 6, and there are many additional informations of .11 management headers. For example, extension tag, HE capabilities, HE operation tag, and special reuse parameter set tag, and tag multi-user EDCA parameter set tag. Please look for movies. This time I use my favorite powerful laptop PC, Alienware M51 M2, and test access point with ASUS RTX 89X. It accepts, of course, Wi-Fi 6 and WPS3 and 5 GHz with 8 antennas, 8 send and 8 receive. And also supports the 2.4 GHz and all the standards, including AC, NA, and so on. Open Alienware, and I change the wireless LAN adapter from Kira to Intel AX200. It's adequate for AX200 capturing. I set my access point SSID Wi-Fi 6, and security is clear text and press apply to check the wireless setting. Then open Comview for Wi-Fi with Wi-Fi 6 AX200 Intel adapters and check my access point. Wi-Fi 6 is here, MAC address, and check channel is 116. So I set the single channel to 116 channel and start capturing. At first, just testing connection clear text access point and test ping. Check Wi-Fi, select access point Wi-Fi 6 and connect clear text network and success and ping, just ping 1.1.1.1 and check connection is success and deassociate again, forget this network and off Wi-Fi. Stop capturing and press stop buttons and this address is stations. It means my iPad Pro address. So use this with quick filter to filter client and check the rate and speed of connections and maximize the window and check protocols and source address and destination address and basic service set ID and source IP, destination IP port and signals and statistics. It is important it uses a high efficiency mode with MCS index with 12, spatial storing with 2, and channel bandwidth with 80 MHz. I check again and scroll the communications. There is a frame information. For example, this frame uses 11AX OFDM and logical speed is 1200 and MCS. So I convert this information as PCAP or PCAP energy format and save communications. Clear text, Wi-Fi 6, PCAP energy, done. Let's open trace file and start dissections. I filter some surplus packet and trimmed to create a simple link up capture data named cleartext.pcapmg. This is a kind of typical link up procedure between stations and access point using Wi-Fi 6. iPad Pro uses private MAC address. A MAC address of prove request and prove response is not the same as later one. There are tons of fields, so we focus main fields and functions. I created some flow graph to visualize the sequence between stations and access point. Frame 1, station receive access point beacon. Frame 2 and frame 3 is probe request and probe response, and frame 4 and frame 5 is open system authentication, and frame 6 and frame 7 is association request and association response. This means the layer 2 link up from frame 8 to frame 14 is a plaintext data stream such as DHCP and ICMP. Frame 15 is disassociation from stations. In actual, I press Wi-Fi off button, pre-check first one frame, beacon from access point. From address is ASUS and destination address is broadcast. And there are some radio tap headers and RF informations, but we focus on 802.11 wireless management headers. Open tagged parameters and check SSID from SSID parameter set. It means SSID Wi-Fi 6. And there are many tags from access point that defines access point specifications. But in this time, I look up for Wi-Fi 6 specified extension tag such as HE capabilities and HE operations and special reuse parameter set and multi-user EDCMA parameter set. At first, HE capability shows AX specifications of access point. Open HE capabilities, there are many informations, but especially open supported HE MCS and NSS set and open RX and TX MCS map. HE capabilities are parts of .11 wireless management header of beacon frame, and they include AP specifications of .11AX. In this time, there are number of spatial stream that supports access point and supported MCS index of HE high efficiency mode MCS index. And also please check the PPE threshold header and open each NSS headers. There are set of area allocations, and that means access point assign resource unit using OFDMA. Then check the frame 2 prove request from stations. I omit some radio tap, .11 radio information and .11 MAC headers, and especially focus on .11 wireless management headers. This frame is a request from stations to check access point that supports Wi-Fi 6. So please check the SSID parameter set is wildcard, because for the first time from station need to collect all access point that reply from access point. So SSID parameter set is blank. Blank means a wildcard SSID. So all the access point answer this request. HE capability header contains many information, but especially HE MAC capabilities and HE PHY capabilities, and supported HEMCS and NSS set and PPE threshold header that includes Wi-Fi 6 original information. Please check supported HEMCS and NSS set header and open PPE threshold and check each NSS header to list up allocations of resource unit. There are many connection settings of Wi-Fi 6 that supports a number of special stream and MCS index and allocations of resource unit. In this time, station supports two special streams and support 996 RU assignment. It contains MCS information, bandwidth, area allocations in HMCS, and NSS set and PPE threshold fields. Please check next frame, frame number 3, prove response from access point. In actual, station sends wildcard SSID, so there are many prove response from another access point using another channels. Let's check the frames, omit that same layer information and open .11 wireless management headers and open tagged parameter headers. There is a SSID of access point is Wi-Fi 6 and many channel and specification information of access point. I omit some and especially focus on .11ax information. There are extension tag, HE capabilities and HE operations and special reuse parameter set and multi-user EDCMA parameter set. HE capability are part of .11 wireless management header of prove response frame, and they include AP's 11x setting to stations. P supports from 1 to 8 special stream and from 0 to 11 index of MCS. There are many set of NSS that includes area allocation. Then check the frame number 4 and frame number 5. It's common in other protocol. Open system algorithm, just check the name of SSID. So there are just a few informations in wireless management header that includes open system algorithm in fixed parameter and status call successful. And there also includes some vendor specific information, because station is Apple, so there is Apple specific vendor information. And authentication process of 11AX is the same as old legacy Wi-Fi. Just check SSID name and using open system algorithm. To link up in actual using Wi-Fi 6, station sends association request in number 6 frame. There are wireless management header, tagged parameter including SSID in SSID parameter set, and there are many extension information such as HE capabilities, HE MAC capability informations, and HE FI capability information, and supported HE MCS and NCS set and PP threshold. I focus on specified informations. Station sends actual connection setting to access point. That includes setting of Wi-Fi 6. Station can accept two special stream, and MCS index is from 0 to 11. And band-wise is 80 MHz, and allocation of resource unit is 242, 484, and 996 assigned. Of course, there are other many setting information, but especially in Wi-Fi 6, we need to check the setting of Wi-Fi 6. Open file capability information header and check the bit information. This flag means the HESU PPDU with 1 HELTF and 0.8 microsecond guard interval is not supported. And this bit means MDP with 4 multiple HELTF and 3.2 microsecond guard interval supported. So logical rate is determined by MCS index from 7.3 to 2 special stream and 996 resource unit and 1.6 microsecond guard interval. So max logical rate is 1134.3 megabit per second. Finally, frame 8 is actual link up message from access point, open wireless management headers, and check status code is successful. That means layer 2 link up successfully. And there is association ID. That means AP recognize the stations and the right log has associated. There is HE capabilities, HE operations, and special reuse of parameter set, and multi-user EDCA parameter set. Please check in details. AP link up layer 2 connection to stations. Association response means AP determined setting configurations, confirmed connection from stations, and link up and start actual data communication with stations. Please open the flag entry and look inside. And connection setting is maximum 80 MHz band-wise and transmit max logical rate as 720 and receive logical max speed is 286. For example, open supported HMCS and NSS set headers and check the RX, TX, HMCS map informations. There are maximum of bandwidth is 80 and supported MCS rate is from 0 to 11 MCS index and the support number of special stream is 1 and 2 because AP supports the 8 special stream but station supports just 2 special stream. So in actual special stream is max and allocations of resource unit is AP shows up 242, 484, 996 and 2996 but station support just 996 so RU is 242, 486 and 996. You may notice Wi-Fi 6 new function that calls BSS coloring. BSS coloring is some mechanism modified CSMA/CA to speed up and utilize bandwidth more effectively. Open BSS color information header, check BSS color and partial BSS color headers. There are many other wireless access points in today's Wi-Fi. You may see tons of SSID if you are in downtown. Wi-Fi 6 uses BSS carrying a group of access point and station connected with access point. In this case, Wi-Fi 6 set color to identify a group of communications. In carrier sense process, AP and station wait for a while. It includes a timer wait and random backoff wait. Then send frames when they receive frame in the same color over RSS signal threshold. It's modified mechanism of CSMACA. And AP changes carrier sense threshold dynamically if the color is not same because it's a other group or other companies or other person's access point. If you are in some airport or stations or some congestion places, it means all other systems use the same Wi-Fi channel, but not me, so I lose an interference threshold. BSS carrying utilizes RF band more efficiently and get better performance, especially in an outdoor, downtown, and other congestion wireless network. We can check them from Wireshark frames. And we also notice another mechanism to look for HMAC capabilities. There are TWT request support header in HMAC capabilities, and you may check some other information in H operation header. There are TWT required flag in H operation parameter flags. And also, you may notice there are some extension bit triggered multi-user beamforming or triggered single-user beamforming and other triggered flag in bits of HFI capabilities. In legacy Wi-Fi, we have to use power management flag, just a one bit in frame control flags to sleep or wake up all stations in BSS. It's very simple, but if there are some small devices, they have to wake up when frame includes a power management bit. So if some packet contains on flag in power management bit, all IoT device or small device have to wake up in same basic service set. So there are new mechanisms in Wi-Fi 6. TWT means the target wake time is a new Wi-Fi 6 mechanism that set individual sleep time between access point and stations. Stations set individual wake time in associations and also include some another information in beacon frames. And anyway, AP sends trigger packet to wake up the stations and stations send back if needed. In this way, Wi-Fi 6 also use channel state information from chipset for beamforming and use trigger to wake up adequately. So TWT is the best solution for low power devices or IoT devices or just a sensor network. From frame 8 to frame 14 is a typical plain text data such as DHCP and CMP. These frames are same as other legacy wireless network. .11x original fields, there are QoS control headers and .11x original HD control header in data frames. HD control header includes a HD flag that uses 11AX. There are aggregate control header that indicates the aggregation setting. I want to show you radio tap header Dot-driven radio information header. But unfortunately, some radio tap header and RF information do not export correctly. For now. Because Dot-driven AX is a new protocol, so compute for Wi-Fi do not export field information in layer 1 correctly. So if you check in proprietary compute for Wi-Fi, you may check the rate type is 11AX and link speed is 1200 and check other .11AX original information. But if we export traces as PKFMG, RF information is not exported correctly and it may lose some fields. For example, packet shows they use just 11A. In actual, of course, we use 11AX, but data rate is actual 1200, but Wireshark shows 49 megabit per second. I, of course, report Richard-san and Guy-san for Wireshark side, but it's a problem from compute for Wi-Fi. So for now, physical information is not exported correctly, but last frame is disassociations. Number 15 frame is a disassociate from stations. It's common in other Wi-Fi standards. Done. And there are another appendix using ping and IPv3 to measure throughput to wired PC using WA2. In this case, SSID and station address and access point address is the same, but we use WA2 with pre-shared key and passphrase is Wireshark. I use SSID is Wi-Fi 6, but this time I use WA2 pre-shared key and passphrase is Wireshark to set my access point. Open compute with administration privilege. I check my WA key with Wireshark and it's okay. SSID is Wi-Fi 6 and use AX with WA2 with pre-shared key AES encryptions. Change directory, IPv3 directory and start IPv3 with S options and move to iPad and once off and on my client because we need to capture complete four-way handshake. Connection is okay and private MAC address is 060F5VDD20FA. Ping address to 1.1.1.1. Ping works correctly. Start performance tool with IPv3 and server address is 10.0.0.212. Let's test again. 237, not so bad. 198, 220. After finishing testing, I stop packet capturing and quick filter to see traffic like this. High efficiency mode, MCS 11, spatial stream 2, channel bandwidth is 80. And I can't decrypt the IPath traffic correctly because we can capture complete four-way handshake. Okay. I also check the packet information that uses 11AX and try to export trace file as PKPMG as WA2 Wi-Fi 6. Actual throughput is about 200 megabit per second. Compute can decrypt WPA2 with pre-shared key, so we can see plain IPv frame if we capture complete for set of EAPOL handshake and enter WPA PSK passphrase in WPA A and web key settings. It's the same as Wireshark. Export file as pkfmg is a plain text IEEE.11 trace file. So it's just an entrance of dissecting Wi-Fi 6. We dissected a simple Wi-Fi 6 connection setup process. You may think this trace packet dissection is not change a lot from legacy trace. Yes, we use the same 802.11 standards. And you may find there are many new headers and fields specialized for .11ax. Wi-Fi 6 and 6E is new protocols, so capture tool and software is now developing. So maybe a few years later, there are another way or another techniques or another software to capture Wi-Fi 6 more efficiently. And of course, Wireshark dissector also will be updated. Use Wireshark to troubleshoot and debug Wi-Fi 6. Thank you very much for watching. And please complete a survey. And if you want to look details in trace files, there are locations URL of trace files. And I also Q&A at the Discord channel too.